Hi, it's Carrie. A few weeks ago, I decided I really wanted to get my computer to generate jazz on its own. What happened? Well, a lot happened, but here's a brief summary.
Hey, look, that loser's listening to Baroque music.
Oh, no. Computer, could you maybe compose your own jazz music?
I'm generating it now.
How was Computery able to generate those jazz masterpieces? Peering deep into Computery's brain exposes three types of neural networks sitting on its hard drive: the character-based LSTM,
hello,
HyperGAN,
hello,
and Pixel CNN. Computery definitely used one of them to generate that lovely jazz music, but I don't know which. I've been meaning to clear up some file space. How about each of you neural nets show me what music you got, and I'll obliterate the two of you that perform the worst. Character-based LSTM, you're up first. Here's Cobblestone's pros and cons. If you want more info, watch part one. So Cobblestone, what you got? And now, after 3 weeks of waiting, it's finally time to see what Cobblestone's got. Cobblestone, take it away. Yeah, you suck. Time to die. Up next is HyperGAN by 255bits, which I've drooled over before. It's a type of generative adversarial network, which I'll describe in more detail in a future video. For now, just know that there are two neural nets, a generator and a discriminator, that are each co-evolving to outsmart the other. If we want our generator to produce images, we can use a deconvolutional neural network. I could be entirely wrong with how this works, but put simply, imagine starting with a low-res image of random pixels. Then, gradually apply specific Instagram filters, Photoshop effects, and upscalings until you, magically get an image of some object. It takes a very complicated, fine-tuned network of convolutions to get this to work.
And that's what HyperGAN does. It looks at thousands of training images from the outside world and then generates new, original images in the same style.
HyperGAN has already proven to be effective at producing good face images, but how the heck are we gonna get it to produce music? Well, if we could just convert music into images, we'd be good to go. Lucky for us, MIDI files are great for that. They explicitly describe the pitch and time of every note played, which we can then graph on a 2D image like this. Up and down mean higher and lower in pitch, in semitone intervals, and right and left mean forward and backward in time, in 20th of a second intervals. A white pixel means a note is being played at that pitch at that time, while a black pixel means no note. But wait, what do these colors mean? Well, HyperGAN works faster on smaller images, so I kept my music images to a size of 96x64. That's 3.2 seconds, which is a little too short for my tastes. Luckily, we can encode more information per pixel by taking apart the red, green, and blue channels of each pixel. Treat each channel as a separate pixel placed horizontally. Now, each of these mini pixels can be turned on or off, independently of the others. In this example, watch as we encode 27 bits of information about our music into just 9 pixels. That simple tactic expands our time window to 192 pixels or 9.6 seconds. Admittedly, this method is not very elegant, failing to use the intuitive spatial nature of convolutional filters. Oh well. I mean, we get these dope-ass looking French flags as a result, so who could complain? Anyway, are there any pros and cons?
Of course!
Of course.
I originally read these pros and cons out loud, but that took too long and the video got boring, so if you want to read them, you can. The main downsides are that there's no sense of time and the training progress can go backwards.
But you know what? None of those caveats even matter, because HyperGAN's training process is by far the prettiest to watch. It's so mesmerizing, it makes me forget all those other problems.
Bye.
Well, that was a lot of hard work, Hypergan. You must have some good music to play for us now. That was nauseating. I hope I never cross paths with you for the rest of my life. Leave immediately. Last up is Pixel CNN, which was written by these people and these people, and Andre Carpathy is in there again? Anyway, this is the neural net I know the least about, but what I believe it does is it traverses the pixels in reading order, one by one. In this way, it's behaving a lot like a recurrent neural net, because you've got iterations performed in sequence, not all at once. Also, no looking into the future! But at each iteration, meaning the microscopic level, Pixel CNN gets its input information by performing convolutions on the surrounding pixels it's seen before, so there is still some aspect of spatial reasoning going on here. So in a way, Pixel CNN is like a blend between Cobblestone and Hypergan, using the powers of sequences and 2D space together. That sounds really corny, like wow wow, there's three options, gosh darn it, sounds just like another boring old Goldilocks story, huh? Too big, too small, just right! Too hot, too cold, just right! Too time-based, not time-based enough, just right! I'd like to point out that because Pixel CNN generates pixels in reading order, there is a specific directionality to its output, top to bottom. You can kind of see that in certain training sessions of Pixel CNN which expose the way it actually works, and especially in how it can be used to complete images missing their bottom half. Is that a good thing or a bad thing? I honestly have no idea, but in my opinion, it's a good thing because music is also directional. It doesn't go backward in pitch, forward in pitch, or backward in time. It only goes forward in time. Okay, so now we're watching Pixel CNN train, and yeah, I'll admit, it's not as pretty as Hypergan training. But I mean, you saw what the networks looked like. Pixel CNN is rigid and square, in contrast to Hypergan's curves and fluids, so of course their outputted images will reflect those traits. And if you're wondering why the music looks rotated, it is. I wanted to make the time dimension correspond to going down on the y-axis instead of the x-axis, because then it more closely aligns with the order in which Pixel CNN draws pixels top to bottom. Now, I'm a little nervous because I already crushed Cobblestone and Hypergan without even knowing if Pixel CNN could do any better. So now it's our only option left. Well, life's just not worth living if you can't take a few risks, right? Why don't you play us your best melodies, Pixel CNN? Hey, that's not too bad. I guess you get to stay on Computery's hard drive after all. Here's a few more of my favorites from Pixel CNN. I'll show you how you can get the full 3-hour album a bit later. Thank you. Now, I know I'll get a bit of criticism on my procedures for this project, so I'll do my best to address them right now. 1. You must be overfitting. That just means the neural network is just regurgitating the training data it saw verbatim. No bro, you ever seen testing loss so low bro? Also, don't judge me by my debug logs. Number 2. You probably cherry-picked the results. Take 2 carry here. I originally said something really cringy, so I'm gonna say it again in a slightly more respectable way. I did cherry pick the results, and I don't feel any shame in doing so. Here's why. I did all these experiments outside academic institutions, so I'm free from all your dumb rules. So free to pick the juiciest cherries.
You're not a real CS student.
I know. But here's 2 things I will point out. 1, we cherry pick even human musicians' work. I mean, when you think of someone like Michael Jackson, you remember him by his classics, right? Nobody remembers his bad stuff. And 2, do you really want to see a non-cherry-picked sample of Computery's work? Do you really want to torment yourself with such relentless misery? Well, then here you go. 3 hours of unedited Computery jazz at the link in the description. Side note, when I converted a bunch of the original jazz MIDI files into images, some of the music had drums in it. Sounds reasonable, right? Well, I tried to get my program to differentiate which instruments were actually piano and which were drums, but I just couldn't. So when I plastered all the piano notes onto that classic 96x64 pixel image, the drum lines got splattered on there too, which they're not supposed to. And keep in mind, these are all supposed to be notes with pitch, so that sounds awful, just listen. Since Pixel CNN was trained on those images, 25% of them with horror in it, Pixel CNN learned to mimic the horror. So what do you get? What do you think you get? What I'm trying to say is just beware of that as you delve into Computery's 700 jazz masterpieces. Also, please avoid P 610. Thanks to all my patrons who are supporting me on Patreon. Tantasar's gonna read your names.
Carrie KH is brought to you at the $5 level by Null Persona, Samuel Eterbrink, Jeremy Neander, Jacob Pearson, Taterbits, Kit Catty J, Benjamin Gordon, Trevor, Dunkel Blau, Brady Wagner, and Mike Koss.
Also, I gotta clarify something. Even though I pretended to crush 2 of the 3 neural networks, I'm not trying to say that they aren't useful. They're like tools with a very specific purpose that they're good at. For Cobblestone, that's producing text. For HyperGAN and Pixel CNN, that's producing images. None of them were supposed to generate music, so the fact that any of the 3 did at all is a miracle. And yes, I went into this jazz production project thinking each neural network I tried would succeed, and then seeing it fail and then trying with a new neural network. So hopefully you can see why this video took so long. And also, I am still planning on making that tutorial of how you can replicate your own music genres with MIDI files, but I think we'll stick with cobblestoming for now, just because it's the most lightweight. Finally, thanks to Hazel Cricket for animating this. You know what, guys? I think this experiment has been a moderate success. I wanted Computery to make me some jazz piano so I wouldn't be bullied, and Computery definitely pulled through. Oh man, I get to go to school in peace now. I can hardly believe it. I'm tearing up with joy just thinking about it. Let's go experience that magnificent bliss.
Hey look, that loser's listening to
jazz.
Let's
no,
beat him up.
It's not what you think. It's not what you think. No.
Bye.